Hello viewers, in this video we shall discuss what is hire purchase system, how to calculate interest under hire purchase system. For videos relating to preparation of ledger accounts in the books of hire vendor, in the books of hire purchaser, what is complete reposition, problems under partial reposition, I have uploaded separate videos. The link I have given it in the description box, you can check it out. Now moving on to this video, what is hire purchase system? Hire purchase is an agreement. It is an agreement which is entered into for selling a product, for selling goods. The hire purchase agreement is entered into. So when we say it is an agreement to sell, there are two parties, the buyer and the seller. But under hire purchase system, the buyer will be called as the hire purchaser and the seller will be called as the hire vendor. So this is what is hire purchase agreement. It is an agreement to sell. The buyer is called as hire purchaser and the seller is called as the hire vendor. Now, what is the difference between hire purchase sale and normal sale? Under a normal sale transaction, the buyer will make immediate payment to the seller. He enters into the agreement to buy a product, he makes payment, gets the goods, and then he leaves. This is normal sales transaction. But under hire purchase agreement, the buyer take possession of the goods, take delivery of the goods from the seller, but he is not settling the full amount. He is going to make the payment partially. He is going to make part payment. So what happens? Possession of the goods is delivered to the buyer, to the hire purchaser, but the ownership of the goods vests with the seller, that is with the hire vendor. The hire vendor will transfer ownership only after the buyer makes a complete payment. After the last installment is paid, then the hire vendor will transfer the ownership to the hire purchaser. So, hire purchase agreement is an agreement to sell where the buyer makes the payment in installments, take delivery of the goods, but ownership is transferred only when the last installment is being paid. This is what is hire purchase agreement. Now, certain important terms which you should know before moving on to interest calculation. They are cash price, hire purchase price, down payment, installment, interest, hire purchaser, hire vendor. These are the important terms that you should know. What is cash price? As I already have shown here, cash price is nothing but the retail price of a product. When a buyer is going to buy a product, he makes immediate payment, then he pays the retail price of the product. So this is the price at which the product is purchased immediately for cash. Then what is hire purchase price? Hire purchase price is the buyer is not going to make the payment immediately. He is going to make the payment in periodical installments. So for this delay in payment, the seller will charge an additional amount called interest. So cash price plus the interest, which is the compensation for delayed payment, that will give you the hire purchase price. How to calculate hire purchase price? Total of all the installments. If you add all the installments that is paid by the buyer to the seller, you will get the hire purchase price. When you are adding the installment, it includes down payment also. So down payment plus all installment amount will give you higher purchase price. The difference between higher purchase price and cash price is only interest. Interest is the difference between higher purchase price and cash price. Now, what is down payment? Down payment is the immediate payment which is paid at the time of entering into the agreement. As soon as the hire purchaser enters into an agreement to buy goods under hire purchase system, he will sign an agreement. While signing the agreement, the immediate payment that is made, that is called as down payment. Then installment, it is also called as hire charges. Installment is the periodical payment which is paid after a set of periodical intervals, say quarterly, half yearly, annually. So after the end of a certain period, the payment is being made. That is called as installment. It includes, that installment includes cash price plus interest. Now, what is interest? Interest is the additional payment or the compensation which is paid by the buyer to the seller for the delay in payment. This compensation is paid for what? For the delay in payment. If the payment is made immediately, then the buyer has to pay only the cash price. Since he is delaying in the payment, additional charges are added, that is interest is added, and he is paying the higher purchase price. So interest is nothing but the compensation which the buyer is paying to the seller for the delayed payment. Then who is the higher purchaser? He is the buyer in a higher purchase agreement. Who is the higher vendor? He is a seller in a higher purchase agreement. So these are the important terms that you should know before we start calculating interest. Now moving on to interest calculation. Calculating interest will depend upon the information that is given in the question. If in the question cash price, installment amount, rate of interest, if all these information are given, how are we going to calculate interest? That method will be different. Say if in the question rate of interest is not given, the first method, cash price, installment amount, rate of interest, these are the information that we need to calculate interest. When all the information is given, how are we going to calculate? If rate of interest is not given, how are we going to calculate? If cash price is not given, how are we going to calculate? If installment amount is not given, how the calculation is going to be done? All these things we will see in this video. And the last method, annuity method, is quite different from the above four methods. That also we will see at the end of the video. On hire purchase system, the total cash price of the car is 15,980, payable 4,000 down and in 3 installment of rupees 6,000, 5,000 and 2,000 at the end of the first, second and third years respectively. Interest is charged at 5% per annum. You are required to calculate interest paid by the hirer each year. Okay, with this information, we will see what are all data is given, what information is given in the question. Cash price. See, the cash price of the car is 15,980. Cash price is given, 4,000 down payment, 3 installments. First installment 6,000, second installment 5,000, third installment 2,000. Rate of interest is 5% per annum. These are the information that is given in the question that I have written it here. Hirer. Hirer means hire purchaser. Okay. Now, when all the information is given, cash price, installment amount, rate of interest, when all the information is given, how are we going to calculate? So we are going to do the calculation in the form of a table. We'll have 5 columns: particulars column, outstanding balance column, installment column, interest column, cash price paid column. In the particulars column, we are going to write the details of what we are going to enter into the rest of the columns. Outstanding balance. In this outstanding balance column, we are going to write the amount that is due or the amount is pending, the amount that is yet to be paid by the buyer to the seller. That is the outstanding balance. In the installment column, we are going to write the installment amount. In the interest column, we are going to write the interest. And in the cash price paid, we are going to write the cash price that is paid by the buyer to the seller in each installment. Okay, now to start the answer, we are starting with the cash price. The cash price of the asset as it is given in the question is 15,980. So I'm writing it. So when the asset is purchased, the outstanding balance is 15,980. This amount is to be paid by the buyer to the seller. Okay. When is the first payment made? The first payment is the down payment. Soon after signing the agreement, the payment that is made by the buyer to the seller is the down payment. So the first payment, down payment, I'm writing it in the particulars column and writing 4,000 rupees in the outstanding balance column. 15,980 was outstanding, out of which 4,000 was paid by the buyer. Now the pending amount, the balance outstanding amount, is 11,980. Hope you understood this. 15,980 was initially outstanding. He has paid 4,000 down payment. So 15,980 minus 4,000, balance amount is 11,980. We are writing this 4,000 in the installment column also, because it is also a part of the installment. So we are writing it in the installment column. I have not calculated interest for this down payment. Why? Because down payment is paid immediately. Soon after signing the agreement, the down payment is paid. Interest will be calculated only for delayed payment. So for down payment, we are not calculating interest. And this down payment is fully cash price. There is no interest included in it. The total amount will come under cash price paid. Okay, after paying down payment, when will the next payment become due? The next payment will become due at the end of the first installment. That is, at the end of the first year, the buyer will make the next payment. So what is the first installment amount? The first installment amount is 6,000. We are writing it in the installment column. Okay, when is the first installment paid? At the end of the second year. There is delay in payment. So we have to calculate interest. On what amount we will calculate interest? We will calculate interest on the outstanding amount. When the first installment became due, the amount outstanding at the end of the first installment is 11,980. So 11,980 into 5%. 5% is the rate of interest that is given in the question. See here, it is charged at 5% per annum. So 11,980 into 5, you will get 599. This is the interest for the first installment. Okay, now we have to calculate cash price. Cash price is very easy. Installment minus interest. 6,000 minus 599. You will get cash price. The cash price is 5,401. Okay, you understood. Now, 11,980 was actually pending. Now, the buyer has paid 5,401 cash price. He has paid 5,401. So, when he makes this payment, from the outstanding amount, we have to deduct this 5,401 and the balance amount that is yet to be paid. Still, 6,579 is pending. The buyer has to make this payment. Okay. After paying the first installment, when will the second payment become due? The second payment will become due at the end of the second year, second installment. What is the amount of the second installment? The second installment amount is 5,000. So I have written 5,000 in the installment column. Now, this is a delayed payment. We are paying it at the end of the second year. Delayed payment, we have to calculate interest. On what amount we have to calculate interest? Only on the outstanding balance. We will calculate interest only on the outstanding balance at the end of the second installment. Don't go back to the calculation. Don't go back and take any other outstanding amount. You have to calculate it on the outstanding balance at the end of the second installment. We are calculating for second installment. So outstanding balance at the end of the second installment, on that value we are calculating 5%. The answer is 329. So 5,000 minus 329. Installment minus interest. Cash price is 4,671. Okay, we are writing it in the outstanding balance also. 6,579 was outstanding. Now in the second installment, the buyer is paying 4,671. So still the further balance, outstanding balance is 1,908. Okay, now when is the next payment to be made? The next payment is end of the third year. Third year is the last installment. He is making payment in three installments. And the third installment is the last installment. Okay. What is the amount of last installment? It is 2000 rupees. So in the installment column, we have written 2000 rupees. Now we have to calculate interest. Whenever you are calculating interest for the last installment, it may be third installment, fourth, fifth, whichever is the last installment. For the last installment alone, when you are calculating, you don't go by the percentage. Don't go by this percentage. Instead, whatever is the outstanding balance, deduct the outstanding balance directly. See, 2000 is the installment amount. The outstanding balance at the end of the third installment is 1,908. Deduct it directly. The answer that you get is 92. This is the interest. Why are we doing like this? Because third installment is the last installment. After making payment of the last installment, there should not be any further outstanding balance. The buyer should settle the claim fully. There should not be any further claim by the buyer. So that is why we are deducting the amount and finding out the interest. So now 2000 minus 92, you will get 1908. write it in the cash price column and in the outstanding balance column also. 1908 minus 1908, 0. So after making the last and final installment, the claim is settled fully. Okay, now add the next column, installment column. 4000, 6000, 5000, 2000. If you add, the answer that you get is 17000. This 17000 is nothing but the higher purchase price. Okay, so total interest 599, 329, 92. If you add, the total interest that is paid by the buyer to the seller is 1020. And if you add the last column, cash price column, you should get 15,980. This answer should be same as the cash price that is given in the question. See, the cash price that is given in the question is 15,980. The same answer you should get here. If you are not getting the same answer, your answer is wrong. You have went somewhere wrong in the calculation. In this video, we have seen how to calculate interest when cash price, installment amount, rate of interest. All the information is given. The remaining methods, when the rate of interest is not given, cash price is not given, installment amount is not given, and annuity method, we will see in the next video. The link I have given it in the description box. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this video useful.